In today's video, we're back with Dan and we're ready to talk all things new in our carry world in the December Rushfaster Carry Roundup.
Well, yeah, Ed, it's only been a month since our last roundup and there's plenty of new things to highlight and talk about.
For those of you who are new to the channel, we do guides and walkthroughs of better gear every week. And at the end of each month, we actually do a carry roundup of all the carry news, new and exciting things happening in the world of carry.
And if you haven't already, please sign up to our mailing list to get a summary of all the gear news we cover in these roundups. And we're also doing a giveaway. So next month, we're going to be giving away a bag. We're going to talk about that later in the program to celebrate hitting 25,000 YouTube subscribers. But you have to be subscribed to our mailing list to win. So pause the video right now, scan the QR code on the screen to sign up and we'll announce the winner next month.
Cool. So Dan, what's first off the plate?
A few new pouches from Bellroy this month. First up, the Bellroy Standing Pouch, which is an accessory organizer that you can set down or hold in your hand, zip open and have everything nice and available. Bellroy have already made a few good pouches that we really like. Their classic pouch, the tech kit, the pencil case. We've done videos on all of these pouches and the links are below and also in the email. But this is just another really cool out there pouch with a slightly different approach. Comes in two sizes, the standard and plus. Plus is just a bit bigger for people who need to carry more. And it's all around a really good little pouch from Bellroy, our friends at Bellroy in Melbourne and Bells Beach. Also, they've released a very similar pouch called the desk pouch. Very similar, but uniquely designed to be used at a desk, whether it's in the home, office, or at a cafe. So with this pouch, the zipper opening is different to the standing pouch. It zips up 3/4 of the way, giving more access and more visibility. As always, really well thought out design and organization. So two new pouches from Bellroy this month, which look pretty cool.
And also from Bellroy, they've actually recently developed some new materials. Bellroy has always kind of been a bit of a pioneer when it comes to innovating new textiles and fabrics. They've really championed that environmentally certified leather. And I really like their venture weave polyester. That's always been a really cool fabric to me. But recently, with the new release of the pouches that Dan was talking about, they've actually gone and developed a new plant-based fabric. It combines Tencel and Refiber technology, which is like lots of really sciencey names, but it's basically combining harvested wood chips, cotton offcuts, coconut-based trims, and they've created this fabric that's really sustainable, and it yields a pretty good overall durability as well. It's definitely a much more earth-friendly alternative to, you know, typical petroleum-based fabrics, and yeah, it can stand up to everyday use, which is really good too. Not only that, but a really small detail, the pouches that use these fabrics, they've actually changed the fabric of that little Bellroy brand tab. There's usually like a brand tab on each of the products and it says Bellroy. It's got the owl logo on it. Usually it's made with the environmentally certified leather, but now they've made it with this thing called Mirum, which is biodegradable, plant-based material crafted from coconut husks, which is really cool. It's a very small detail, but you know, Bellroy's always about the little details. So at the time of this video, when it's released, the material, it'll come out in gumnut and smoke blue. So if you're interested in those fabrics and you're keen about, you know, sustainable materials, then check out those colors.
Yeah, that's really good news from Bellroy. I mean, off the back of Orbit Key doing something for the environment last month and Bellroy coming in with some new fabrics that are better choices, that's really good news from two of our favorite carry brands. So yeah, if you're interested in checking out any of the new pouches that Bellroy have released or those fabrics, Ed's going to be making a video soon, aren't you, Ed, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. We've actually got, just to give you a bit of a...
Oh, you got some there?
Yeah, Bellroy sent us some of these. These aren't... one of them is the limestone colour and the other one is just the normal blue colour. So these aren't the actual plant-based material ones, but still nevertheless really cool pouches that we'll look into later.
Yeah, it's slightly bigger. That one on the left is slightly bigger than I expected. But is that the bigger size?
Yeah, this one's the desk pouch. Yeah, right. That opens up like 3/4 and kind of like, yeah, you can see everything inside.
Yeah, nice.
Really cool.
What else you got there for us, Ed?
We've got some news from Loctote, very small brand that really exploded on Kickstarter with their Loctote flak sack. It was an anti-theft bag that featured, you know, these incredibly strong materials made of Kevlar. You couldn't cut through it, that sort of stuff. We actually have a detailed walkthrough of the original flak sack. So Dan actually talks through all the features and all the materials. You can check that out in the links below as well. We'll leave a link there. But Loctote have actually gone and designed an entire new collection. It's called the Mobility Collection. It's out on Kickstarter. They've taken the same approach as they did with the original flak sack. You know, everyday use, super durable, anti-theft, and it's got a heritage aesthetic to it as well. So in the collection, there's a little backpack. It's called the Mini Cinch Pack. And then there is a sling bag, as well as a waist pouch, passport case, card holder, neck pouch, and even a camera wrist strap. So all these kind of everyday use items. They're still using the super crazy Kevlar cut resistant material. It's still designed around that lock and leave system where you can just take the bag off, wrap it around a pole, lock it, and it's super secure. And you know, we really like the original approach to the flak sack. So it'll definitely be something interesting to keep an eye out and see how it performs on Kickstarter.
Definitely a good range of bags for going to the beach. Like if you ride to the beach or something, or you drive to the beach, you need to put your key somewhere, you can attach one of those bags to a pole and yeah, no one's going to be able to take it. Actually, it would be a really good idea. We should go to the beach one day and actually just put a Loctote bag to the pole and just sort of sit there and watch and see what kind of reactions you get from people, whether they come and try and take it or something. But when I did the review on those bags, it's surprising how they can make a bag so theft resistant and strong that you just can't get into it. I was really impressed with them. So it looks like more great stuff from Loctote.
Okay, so Dan, Boundary Supply is up next. What's new from them?
Yeah, Boundary Supply, another favorite brand. Definitely a favorite brand of you, isn't it, Ed? They have released a new daily backpack called the Renan Day Pack. So it's a 22 liter bag and it comes in both the X-Pack fabric and then new RE3 recycled material. So another environmentally friendly thing coming out of a carry brand, which is great to see. It features the classic backpack silhouette and is stocked with Boundary's technical build quality and ability to work with their modular accessories. They've also made a sling bag and an accessory pouch that is part of the series.
Yeah, and it looks like a really cool collection overall. Like, again, yeah, they're going ahead with super sustainable materials. Like, they're already pretty conscious about their social and environmental values. You know, all of their materials are Blue Sign approved, things like that. But now they've gone and developed and partnered with other brands to make further environmentally friendly materials, this entire recycled collection. So that's really cool. They actually sent me the Renan backpack. You can see it's like I've been using it a little bit, just field testing it, trying it out. It's a really cool everyday bag, and I haven't got a chance to test out the sling, but again, it's similar materials, feels really nice. But something that I've been really liking is just this little pouch that they've made. It's really easy to use, and it's got that nice yellow inside, hopefully you can see that. And it's got a little bit of organization, just a really nice little pouch. Probably quite similar to the Bellroy ones. But yeah, we'll be seeing a video on that stuff very soon.
Ed, you're pulling out all the surprises today. You've got all the new releases there tucked away behind your desk. You didn't tell me anything about this.
That's right.
So this series is a general purpose series, unlike their other bags, which are fairly more technical and targeted towards creative and photographers. So this one, yeah, just a more general purpose, everyday carry sort of backpack and range. And speaking of photographers, Ed, you've got some news from Shimoda.
News, but not about new products. Just want to highlight a really huge sale from Shimoda. If you're not familiar with Shimoda, they make some of the best adventure bags that are fitted specifically for photography. So really technical, kind of hiking, outdoors backpacks, that sort of thing. And they're having a 40% off sale on their select Explore backpacks, which is a really huge thing for Shimoda. The 40 and the 60 liter Explore backpacks and the starter kits, that they have like a few inserts and stuff like that, those starter kits, they're all on sale. So with any of those pieces, you can save at least $100, $100 USD, and some of them even more. So really big savings on those. So we just wanted to highlight that sale because, you know, they're a great brand and they make some crazy bags. So if you're interested, you could really snag a really good deal. Dan, you've got something from Evergoods. We looked at Evergoods last roundup. What is it this time?
Ed, so not a new product this time, but a new color. Evergoods have a huge reputation when it comes to making thoughtfully and incredibly designed bags. But right now they've just released a limited edition Signal Blue colorway. So all of their bags are now available in this punchy blue. The access pouch is out of stock, unfortunately, but everything else is available right now at the time of shooting. So if you love Evergoods and you're looking to grab a bag that is not your typical black bag, it is a little blue, check it out in the links in the description below or in the email that we've sent you with this video. And so yeah, that's it from Evergoods. And Ed, last but not least, you have some news from Matador.
Yeah, that's right. Matador, they're known for their, you know, expedition grade packable backpacks. They create some of the best bags that combine, you know, durability and lightweight packability. They're like top shelf when it comes to that stuff. And they've made two new ultralight frame bags that are engineered for outdoor adventures. So they still boast the ultralight weights. They can still be packed down for efficient travel. It includes a flexible frame. So with most heavy duty hiking bags, there's some sort of body frame that, you know, kind of ergonomically supports heavy loads. The Beast 18 and the Beast 28, they're the new bags. They have that flexible frame. So there's some rigidity that contours to your body, but it's still flexible enough to pack down into a stowable state, which is, you know, crazy. They're hydration compatible as well. You can put a little hydration bladder in there. They have daisy chain webbing, so you can put in all your trekking poles, your axes, whatever you need. And they also come with a detachable waist belt and a sternum strap, which is really good. As it's been with all Matador's collections, they're, you know, really pushing the envelope when it comes to packable adventure gear. So yeah, really cool stuff from them, the Beast 18 and the Beast 28.
Well, that looks like a pretty nice backpack there from Matador, and yeah, definitely something to keep an eye out on. And well, guys, that's it for this time, for this month's carry roundup. We really hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, and as we mentioned in the last carry roundup, we're closing in on 25k subscribers. So we're going to hit that milestone in just a few days, I reckon. It's so exciting for our channel, and we just want to thank everyone who has subscribed to the channel and watch our videos each week. It's been an incredible journey so far, and we really look forward to evolving the channel further in 2021. And so, as promised, we're running a giveaway in celebration of that. So we've teamed up with our good friends over at Moment, and we're going to give away their new Moment Travelwear backpack. It's a terrific daily backpack. It looks super low profile and it's subdued, but it's all packed with thoughtful features and it's a super comfortable daily backpack. With that, you'll also get the tech organizer and the battery organizer, so you can, you know, store and organize all your camera and tech gear in that bag. So that's all part of the giveaway. All you need to do is subscribe to our email newsletter right now. So right now, using the QR code on the screen or in the link below in the description. And we'll draw the winner in next month's carry roundup, and we'll announce it right here on the channel. So go do that. Subscribe to our newsletter right now for your chance to win.
Yeah, looks like a pretty pretty good prize there from Moment, and we thank those guys so much for sponsoring that prize. Guys, that's it for this month. Thanks so much for watching and subscribing in 2020, and we're gonna see you next year.
Yeah, thanks so much, everyone. Happy holidays, stay safe, and we'll catch you in 2021.